Have you ever wondered that the things you see around you are not always what they look like? They might have deeper meaning, or there might be something beyond general understanding. Wait, let me put it in this way. Just close your eyes and try to imagine an alien. Let me guess what you all would have imagined. A green figure with a huge unevenly shaped head, big eyes, three fingers in each hand, and a UFO in the background. Well, most of us would have imagined a figure of this sort, because this is what is shown to us in movies, and we generally don't visualize anything beyond this, because we have picturized aliens this way. But a four-year-old kid might have some crazy-looking creature in his mind, if we allow him to look beyond. Just give it a thought.
You're on mute. On कर ले भाई.
Sorry. अभी अभी आवाज आ रही है?
हाँ हाँ आ रही है, आ रही है.
Clearly.
यार कोई अपना कैमरा ऑन कर दो, मतलब बस मेरा शक्ल दिख रहा है.
Just a second.
Sorry, मैं बाहर हूँ.
Okay.
You find this way, thanks.
Oh. ठीक है फिर.
Listen, I have something important to talk about Panorama. कि हम लोग के जो बाद के videos है, latest videos, उस पे we're not getting enough views. बस पहले वीडियो पे 1000+ व्यूज आया था, उसके बाद अच्छे व्यूज नहीं आ रहे थे. तो आई गेस वी नीड टू थिंक ऑफ समथिंग न्यू आइडियाज. तो किसी के पास है तो प्लीज कम अप.
मैंने भी ये नोटिस किया था, मेरे पास भी कुछ आइडियाज है, पर मुझे पता नहीं वर्क करेंगे या नहीं. लेट्स डिस्कस. आउच, ये मच्छर, आई जस्ट हेट देम. मैं चाहती हूँ ये दुनिया से चले जाए हमेशा मुझे के लिए.
नो ब्रो, व्हाट इफ दे आर इक्वली इंपॉर्टेंट?
How can they be so important? मतलब बस diseases spread करते हैं और क्या करते हैं?
अरे अरे guys, listen. Like I totally understand your frustrations toward these bloodthirsty insects. लेकिन wiping them all out of extinction, I don't think it's a really good solution. Like no one can do that, right? And also, if they live on this earth, which means that there must be some reason for their existence, no?
हाँ.
है कि नहीं?
What would happen if all the mosquitoes disappeared?
Science, where you will find
deeper insights into science.
So let's begin.
Mosquitoes belong to a broad group of insects called flies that can be found all over the world. They are the most dangerous predators, responsible for the deaths of millions of people each year by spreading diseases like malaria, dengue, Zika virus, yellow fevers, and others through their itching bites.
You would be surprised to know that there are almost 3,500 mosquito species, yet only a few hundreds of them, that is around 6% of them, consume human blood. Now the question arises, how do they bite?
After finding their prime target, a mosquito will spit some saliva on your skin, which acts as an antiseptic in order to numb the area so that you do not notice their evil intentions. Then it buries a part of its mouth deep into the target's skin called the proboscis, which resembles a straw. With its proboscis beneath your skin, the mosquito searches for a blood vessel and releases saliva into the wound, which contains a substance called anticoagulant that keeps your blood flowing. If it succeeds, a mosquito can drink blood up to 3 times its body weight. An Asian tiger mosquito, for example, would drink approximately 0.005 ml of blood, and that's the volume of a single mustard seed. It can spread potentially fatal diseases like malaria, dengue, yellow fever, and Zika, and if not, it will leave an uncomfortable, itchy red bump around the bite, otherwise known as Skeeter syndrome. And if you were unlucky, you could have other allergic reactions like lesions, bruises, or even swelling in the throat. Only female mosquitoes bite, and that's because they need blood to make their proteins that are needed for them to lay their eggs. Mosquitoes are surprisingly picky too. They tend to prefer men, pregnant women, and people who are overweight. But perhaps their favorite victims are people with blood group O. Mosquitoes tend to prefer those with warmer body temperatures and those who breathe heavily. These insects are typically drawn to chemical smells that come from our body and exhaled breath. They can sense carbon dioxide and octanol, which is also produced as a part of body odor.
So, if you fit the criteria, congrats! 1 million little insects could be feasting on you. Now, a new question arises. How do they spread diseases?
They spread diseases by biting someone who has a particular disease and then biting you and injecting their saliva into your system. The mosquito's saliva then enters your bloodstream, leading you to get infected with whatever virus or bacteria that it picked up. Mosquitoes do not only affect humans, but they also affect animals and farm livestock all over the world. A single bite can be deadly.
So now tell me, Stella, we know we can get rid of these insects by certain home remedies that we find on internet, such as keeping a dish of soapy water or beer or alcohol, or even keeping mosquito repellent plants, etc. But here we are talking about eradicating the mosquito species. Is that even possible? How can that be done? And also, what if all the mosquitoes become extinct? Will it affect our ecosystem?
Well, there is no perfect answer to this question, but yes, there were some ongoing trials for genetically modified mosquitoes, also known as GM mosquitoes, by the biotechnology company Oxitec. They used a particular type of mosquito, that is, wild Aedes aegypti, because these mosquitoes spread viruses including dengue, Zika, and chikungunya. These were named as OX5034GM.
Okay, so now tell me how they are produced.
GM mosquitoes are produced in a lab to carry 2 types of genes. The first one is a self-limiting gene that prevents female mosquito offspring from surviving to adulthood. And the next one is a fluorescent marker gene that glows under a special red light. This allows researchers to identify GM mosquitoes in the wild. GM mosquitoes produced in the lab lay eggs. These eggs carry the self-limiting or the fluorescent marker genes. GM mosquito eggs that carry the self-limiting gene are released into an area. Once they have hatched and developed through to the adult stage, they are available to mate with the wild females. These genes are passed on to the offsprings. The female offspring die before they become adults. The expected result is that the number of Aedes aegypti mosquitoes in the area decrease. The EPA evaluated that there is no risk to people, animals, or the environment. Instead, GM mosquitoes are meant to help prevent disease outbreaks. Releasing GM mosquitoes over several months can reduce the number of mosquitoes that can cause outbreaks by spreading germs. Now, mosquitoes would be destroyed if enough of a genetically modified mosquitoes had sterile offsprings, which might take decades. There are over 3,500 species of mosquitoes, out of which Anopheles, Aedes and Culex are the ones that cause majority of diseases. As we previously discussed, GM mosquitoes are tested in the US to control the population of female Aedes aegypti. But no one can just snap their fingers and wipe them out of existence, right? With so many negatives, these insects have some positive effect too. Like male mosquitoes that only feed off nectar contribute in the process of pollination, especially for orchids. So some plants might suffer due to lack of pollination if these mosquitoes just stop visiting them. Insect-eating animals such as birds, bats, spiders and dragonflies love to include mosquitoes in their diet, but not as a main course. They wouldn't go hungry without mosquitoes because they would eat enough of something else. Mosquito larvae consumes organic matter in wetlands, helping recycle nutrients back into the ecosystem. But a lot of other larvae-dwelling creatures also do the same and could easily handle the job without mosquitoes as well. Now, it may seem that mosquitoes are not very significant or valuable. But who knows if some new chemical found in them might be of greater use in the future.
Now I get that, ki agar koi cheez exist karti hai, then there is always a reason for its existence.
That's absolutely correct.
If you like our video, kindly like, share, subscribe and press the bell icon so that you never miss any of our videos.
And also follow us on Instagram, the link of which is provided in the description below.
Till then, stay tuned, stay curious.